in just a second, we'll start the scan, okay?
Okay.
All right, here we go.
The focus of our research is memory and how it develops. So we know that there are age-related improvements in memory across childhood, and our lab is trying to find out about some of the factors that are driving that change.
And so while you're in there, we'll be taking pictures of inside of your brain, and it does this by using a bunch of big magnets.
Okay.
My role in the memory development lab is a research assistant. So I work with children of different ages in the community and also in our lab to study memory development.
I have a question about the scan of the picture. Do you like zoom in and can you see what's going on in your thoughts?
Well, we can't see what's going on in your thoughts, so we're just looking at what your brain actually looks like.
It's very important to understand the link between brain development and memory in children. First, to learn about memory, we know that memory is involved in learning in the classroom. We know that it's involved in autobiographical memory. These memories make up who we are. Memory is also involved in eyewitness testimony and things like that. So for all those reasons, we're interested in memory. And we want to know how it got there, why it develops in the way that it does. Is, and that's showing in blue, and the hippocampus is in yellow. And what we're going to do together is manually segment the hippocampus into the subregions, the head, body, and the tail.
My role in this particular study is to play games with children to help them understand what it's like to get an MRI and to talk to them about some things that they've done recently to look at their memory. Okay, and just lay on your back and face up towards this, all right? So now you're going to play a game like you're in the MRI, like I told you about earlier. So during this, you just want to stay really still, okay? So I'm going to put these around your head and just try really hard not to knock them over, okay? I'm going to put this on your forehead, so try not to let it fall off. So I'm going to put on a movie for you.
Well, after that, he let me go to the docking area, and I parked the boat myself, and it was really hard, though.
Yeah. So we play these games with them to try to make them feel more comfortable with it, to show them that it's not really that scary. We also make sure that they know exactly what's going to happen when they're in there.
Or this button right here will be the picture on the right, okay?
Okay.
All right, so next we'll go ahead and put our headphones on. And then I'll give you this squeezy ball, so if at any point you want to come out of the scanner, then just squeeze this and that'll let you know that you're ready to come out, okay?
Okay.
All right, so go ahead and lie back. And then I'll put our funny looking helmet on next. And this has the mirror so that you can see the pictures behind you, okay? All right, when you're ready, we can go. First, we're gonna go up. And are you feeling okay?
Yes.
All right, cool. So when you're ready, I'll send you back in. Ready?
Yes.
It's important to have undergraduate students as well as graduate students and professors work on a research team together and have everyone be integrated together working on research projects, because everyone brings in different types of expertise and different life experiences, more diverse ideas, and that helps science, that helps move the field forward. That research helps them develop communication skills, both verbal skills and written skills. So for example, presenting their work at local or national conferences, or co-authoring publications.
I'm really interested in the brain. I'm particularly interested in how the brain affects our behaviors. And I feel that working in healthcare would give me the opportunity to explore that a little more, but also help people who are experiencing maybe abnormal changes in their brain.
I got into this work because of the experiences that I had as an undergraduate student, and I want to make sure that undergraduates at UNCG also get that experience. And I think that's something that is shared by other faculty in the department. In our department, over 150 undergraduate students every year get research experience.
I think working in the lab has probably been the best thing I did in my undergraduate career, just because it did give me the opportunity to do a lot of different things that I wouldn't have been able to do in just the classroom, and to meet a lot of people who are good connections and who I can go and talk to about my worries about applying to professional school, and to also have a faculty mentor who I can talk to about all of these things.